back to my channel, or welcome if you're new here. Today's video I am doing because this is a video that I needed to watch last week, and it is how I keep myself sane and my healthy habits that I implement when I am very stressed. So I'm a senior in college. We just had our midterms. I know finals are coming up. I also do YouTube and am a small business owner, and I'm sure that like me, you do a lot of things and are very stressed. So I'm going to be sharing 10 healthy things that I do in my days or weeks that are super stressful that literally make me feel okay, that make me feel sane, that make me feel like I can tackle whatever's next on my to-do list. Also, I've never done a video where I spoke into the mic, but my camera is actually pretty far away from me because I'm using a different lens and whatnot. So let me know if you like the audio in this. We'll see how it goes. All right, so I'm just gonna get straight into this. So the first thing that I do is the smallest, but that is just little bits of happiness throughout my day. You may already have some of these things. I know everyone loves a good coffee. I love going out to a coffee shop and doing work from there, but sometimes I really just don't want to pay $6 or $7 for a drink. And so when I have a lot of work to do, I don't want to get distracted either. So I literally just want to sit here at my apartment and get work done because I'm feeling stressed about it, right? So what I do is I have come up with a signature one or two drinks that I like to make from home that make me feel so like excited, like I would be getting a matcha or a chai or a latte at a Starbucks or coffee shop, but I can make it here at home. A few things that I do to make mine extra special is, first off, I've been loving dirty chai, so I've been making espresso in my Nespresso. Just having that coffee maker, I love it, and I'm so thankful I invested in it a year ago. I'll add some chai concentrate that I bought from a small business and make my own dirty chai. I swear it's just as good as the ones you buy at a coffee shop. I also love milk frothers, whether you use a handheld frother or a machine, and adding some like vanilla syrup, cinnamon, or sugar to your milk before you froth it so that when it becomes a cold foam or a foam, it's sweetened and it's not just like plain oat milk. Of course, yeah, using the milk you like. And then lastly is using glasses and straws that you like. I have a few different favorites here in the apartment, but I just bought these off of Amazon. They're super trendy. I feel like every influencer has these glass beer glasses and clear reusable straws. They're actually pretty affordable, so I will link them below, but they're so cute. You can see the cold foam perfectly on top, and I just love being able to make myself a nice drink while not having to leave my apartment. So this next tip is actually the biggest one, and if you hear anything from this video, this is what I want you to hear. But it is okay to be so stressed and overwhelmed that you feel like you need to talk to someone else about it. By this, I mean going to therapy. This semester, I've been having days where I would just, you know, cry from being so stressed and overwhelmed with school and work and YouTube and just all the things that come with that and being a 22-year-old. And so BetterHelp actually reached out to me to sponsor a video, and I had heard a lot of other podcasters and YouTubers talk about it. I knew it was a really reliable and amazing opportunity, but since I had never used the service or any therapy before, I wanted to try it out before I recommended it to you guys. So I have been meeting with my own therapist through BetterHelp for the past few weeks and have really loved it. So I want to share a little bit about today's sponsor, BetterHelp, and how you guys can have an amazing offer to start your therapy journey through this video. I wanted to get a little bit cozier of a setting here to talk about therapy because I know it can be scary. I know I was very nervous before my first session, but if there is something interfering with your happiness or preventing you from achieving your goals, they will assess your needs and match you with your own licensed professional therapist. And you can start communicating within 48 hours. It is not a crisis line. It is not self-help. It is professional therapy done securely online. There is a broad range of expertise in BetterHelp's 20,000 plus therapist network, which may not be locally available in many areas. So I know my therapist that I have been talking to is specifically for helping you manage stress, overwhelm, self-care, work-life balance. Those are the things he specializes in. so he was a perfect match for me. I also wanted a Christian therapist, so when I was creating my account, I was able to select that I would like to have a therapist who is also a Christian, just so you know, we could have that same foundation, that same background. The service is available for clients worldwide, and you can log into your account anytime and send a message to your therapist. You'll get a timely and thoughtful response, plus you can schedule weekly video or phone sessions, so you won't have to sit in an uncomfortable waiting room as with traditional therapy. So I decided to do Zoom meetings with my therapist. I just felt like that was the most personal. I could get the most out of it, but you can even do phone calls or even just messaging through the platform. BetterHelp is committed to facilitating great therapeutic matches, so they make it easy and free to change therapists if needed. It's more affordable than traditional offline therapy, and financial aid is available. BetterHelp wants you to live your happiest life, and of course I do too. You guys mean the world to me, and I just want you all to be feeling your best. And so they are giving you a special offer through this video. You can get 10% off your first month at betterhelp.com/HannahAshton. It will be in the description box and in the comments for you to check out. And let's get on with my other healthy habits. All right, so my next one, you may be like, Hannah, I don't want to hear this. I know this, but it is working out. And I'm not saying that you're working out and you're following a strict regimen and you're watching everything you eat and you're working out to look your best or to lose weight or to bulk up. I've really found that this semester, I have been so consumed by work that I haven't really had time for those thoughts, which is actually really nice, like kind of have a better relationship with working out and with food. I literally work out because it clears my mind. In the mornings, I go to class, I come home, my brain is so foggy that literally I crave working out and just sweating so that my brain clears. And I love the feeling of when I'm like just walking on the treadmill. Like, I don't even do super intense workouts. I will literally walk on the treadmill at an incline, watch some YouTube, listen to music, listen to a podcast, or walk outside if it's nice out. And I can just feel my body feeling better immediately. And if you're not implementing working out into a weekly schedule and you're super stressed, literally this is the one thing you can add in that may seem like a lot to start, but you'll be so thankful that you did it, and it will eventually just become second nature. Like, oh my gosh, I need to go on my morning walk today. Or, oh my goodness, I want to do a little bit of a yoga practice before bed tonight. And you'll just start to crave kind of that feeling of clarity that comes when working out. And also, it's just an amazing way to stay healthy physically, also mentally, and it's free. My next tip is scheduling your weeks out in advance. I know I feel overwhelmed when I know that there's something, you know, towards the end of the week that I have to do, but I don't know exactly what it is, or I don't know how long it's going to take me, and it's just kind of looming there, you know? It's like the feeling of having something to do is worse than actually doing the thing. And so that's why I hate procrastinating. But what I do is I get my Dream Achieve workbook, my planner, shameless plug because I use it every single day, and I have for 2 years. So I literally swear by this planner. And so what I do is I write my to-do list on Sundays for every day of the week, things I know I need to do. So if I'm going to work out Monday, Tuesday, Thursday, Friday, I'll add that. If I know I have a paper due Wednesday, a project due Friday, I'll add in all of that. And then each morning is when I time block my day. Here is an actual look at my planner. I'm almost done with it. I'm on my last month. This is my weekly spread. Literally my goal for last week, get through midterms, okay? Here is my to-do list for every day. As you can see, some days I got everything done, some days I didn't. And then every day, this is kind of what my time blocking looks like. So putting in when I wake up, what I'm doing, when I'm in class, when I have free time, kind of goes down into sometimes dinner, sometimes I just stop in the middle of the day. But yeah, real life look at how my planner looks after a week of time blocking. It literally gives me such a peace of mind when I know how much I can fit into my day and how much I can actually get done. So that is why I time block. That is why I schedule my week out at the beginning of the week, and I highly recommend doing it.
It's self-explanatory, but I think time blocking is really important to stay productive. I time block, you know, okay, I'm going to set this amount of time to answer emails. I'm going to set this time to have team meetings. I'm going to set this time to do personal home stuff. I'm going to set this time to do self-care. And then I'm going to set this time to spend time with friends and family.
The next habit I started in September, and that is journaling daily. So I have like a goal setting journal that I use in the mornings. And in the mornings is when I do a very positive journal. You know, my goals for that day, something I'm proud of, what I'm grateful for, prayers, whatever it may be. It's a very positive journal entry, and I normally just do a page, sometimes with a prompt, sometimes just a free write, and that's just, I love that time in my morning. It's like my new favorite thing to do in the mornings. No matter what I have that day, I'm gonna journal. And then I have a separate journal that's more like a diary, where if I'm like, you know, feeling kind of down and just wanna journal my thoughts, I'll put that into more of my diary rather than my morning journal. I don't do that daily. Could be once a week, could be a few times a month, just kind of depends on when I feel like it. But that is my journaling process and I love it. My next tip is to spend time with people you love, with the caveat of having no phones allowed. I love my friend group because for the most part, when we're like hanging out, playing games, people aren't consumed on their phones. When we go to dinner, I never really see anyone on their phone. And that is something that is so sacred to me and I love, because when I'm hanging out with my friends, I really like, unless I'm showing them something on my phone, I put it away. Tell my boyfriend, like, I'll text you after we hang out. I just love to be really engaged, and you'll get so much more out of the time you're spending with them if you're not distracted by your phones. So this, I think it depends if you're an introvert or an extrovert on which maybe will refuel you. If you're having a super stressful week and you're an introvert, maybe hanging out with your friends isn't the best thing to do, and you need to spend those nights in tending to yourself, doing self-care that you love. But for me, even though I love spending, you know, self-care nights in and doing stuff by myself, I really get recharged with my friends because I'm not thinking about work or school, and I just am laughing and having a good time and talking. When I have those days to myself, I'm still usually thinking about what I need to do. So figure out how you can unplug from your to-do list, how you can unplug from all the stress. And even if you can't do that during your really busy season, plan it for right after. So do that on the weekends. Or if you can, put a little bit of that into every day. And that kind of goes into my next tip, which is if you are a social person, but you're super busy and you don't have time for social things, get that time in while multitasking. So may sound bad, but for me, this looks like if I really want to get together with a friend and catch up, but I am super busy, I'll kill two birds with one stone, as the saying goes, and go on a walk outside with them for an hour. And that, you know, I'm getting my workout in, I'm getting my catch up time in, I'm getting some time outside, not on my computer in. So it feels more productive, which obviously, not every time I hang out with my friends, I want to feel productive, but just in those really busy weeks and seasons, it helps me to know that I can multitask a few things in my day, because every hour counts. Another way I do that is I will call my mom or my boyfriend while I'm driving somewhere, so kind of multitasking there, or while I'm cooking dinner, doing something that, you know, I can kind of talk on the phone and get that social aspect, get to catch up with someone, but also be doing something else that I already had to do. All right, so now for my introverts, I recommend doing something that you love by yourself as well. This can be a great time to just reflect and build that relationship with yourself, which is still so important. So again, when you're super busy, it may feel like you have no extra time, but I just went to the mall the day before my birthday and just walked around the mall for like 30 minutes. It wasn't even, you know, a huge afternoon thing, but just after class, I was like, you know what? I'm just gonna go walk around the mall. I love to window shop by myself. It's one of like a peaceful thing I do. I don't really spend any money. I just walk around in a nice mall and kind of window shop. Maybe it's doing something creative. Maybe it's watching your favorite movie. Oh, this is something I also do. If I'm not super tired, I'll like start a new book, or I'll watch one of my favorite chick flick movies in bed by myself, just on my iPad. I love watching movies and TV with friends, but there's just something about like me being by myself, watching a good movie in my bed, I just love. So I'll do things like that as well. My habit number 9 is start adding new podcasts or music into your day. This is awesome because I listen to music when I'm doing work or when I'm driving or when I'm working out. And so adding a little pep into those times that may feel mundane is super nice. So finding a new artist you love.
Not me discovering BTS this week. I know I'm behind on it. I know you guys have been fangirling.
A new playlist, or like I said, a new podcast that you can look forward to every week is a great way to add some freshness and something new into a very routine day or week. And my last tip is to have your go-to recipes. So when I'm super busy and stressed, I do not want to be on Pinterest looking up, you know, hour-long recipes. That's so fun for when I want to do something fun and de-stress and have time. But when I'm super busy, I like just have my go-to meals, my go-to breakfast, my go-to lunch, my go-to dinners, and just switch them out, have my leftovers, grab some snacks, because you are not going to want to feel like cooking when your battery is at zero. And so just having healthy, nutritious, yummy meals that you love, that are easy to make, you don't have to look up a recipe, you can whip up in, you know, 30 minutes or less, those are great to have on hand. So when you're not busy, start practicing some of those recipes and get them down so that when you are busy, you already got a go-to and you don't have to think about it. All right, so that is it for this video. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope it was helpful. Maybe if you learned a new habit that you're gonna start implementing, leave it in the comments, or if you have one I didn't mention, let me know, because I'd love to try it out as well. Thank you guys so much for watching, and thank you so much to BetterHelp for sponsoring this video and getting me into therapy as well, and all the amazing work that you guys are doing. So thank you all again, and I will talk to you in my next video. Bye, peace out.